We want to solve the system of equations using the elimination method, sometimes called the addition method. To solve this system of equations, we're looking for an ordered pair, or an x and y value that's going to satisfy both of the equations. The idea of the elimination method is we want to add these two equations together and eliminate the x terms or y terms. Well, if we want to sum these two equations and eliminate one of the variables, either the x terms or the y terms will have to be opposites of one another. So the first step here is to put the equations in standard form, meaning we want the x terms and the y terms on the left and the constant on the right. So for this first equation, we'll add 21 to both sides. So we'd have 4x minus 2y equals 21. And then for the second equation, we'll add 8y to both sides. So we would have 3x plus 8y equals 11. If we add the two equations together now, neither of the variable terms are opposites. So we have to decide whether we want to eliminate the x terms or the y terms. Looking at the x terms, we have a 4x and a 3x. The least common multiple of 3 and 4 would be 12. So one of these terms would have to be negative 12x, and the other would have to be positive 12x. To do that, notice how we have to multiply both the first and second equation by a constant. But if we look at the y terms, here we have minus 2y and here we have plus 8y. If we multiplied this first equation by 4, this would be minus 8y, this would be plus 8y, and the y terms would be opposites. So let's eliminate the y terms by multiplying this first equation by positive 4, and then we'll leave the second equation the same. And this will eliminate the y terms. So we multiply everything by 4 here, we'll have 16x minus 8y equals 84. Second equation is going to stay the same, so we have 3x plus 8y equals 11. And now we'll add these two equations together. Notice we'll have 19x minus 8y plus 8y, that would sum to 0. And then we have 84 plus 11, that'd be 95. So now we'll divide both sides by 19 to determine the value of x. 95 divided by 19 is equal to 5. So we know x must equal 5. But we're not done, because remember, our solution is an ordered pair. We know the x value must be 5. But we still have to go back and determine the value of y. And we do this by performing back substitution into one of the original equations. So for example, if we call this equation 1 and this equation 2, let's substitute 5 for x in equation 1. So using equation 1, we would have 4 times 5 minus 2y minus 21 equals 0. Well, this would be 20 minus 2y minus 21 equals 0. Well, 20 minus 21 is negative 1. So we have negative 1 minus 2y equals 0. So add 1 to both sides would give us negative 2y equals 1. Divide both sides by negative 2. We have y equals negative 1/2. So our solution is the ordered pair 5 comma negative 1/2, or x equals 5 and y equals negative 1/2. And because we have one unique solution, this means the system is consistent because it has at least one solution, and the equations are different, so the equations are independent. If we want to verify these two solutions, we would have to substitute these values into both of the equations, and let's go ahead and do that. So for equation 1, we would have 5 times 4 minus 2 times negative 1/2 minus 21 equals 0. This will be 20 plus 1 minus 21 equals 0, and that checks. We have 0 equals 0. And then for equation 2, we would have 3 times 5 equals 11 minus 8 times negative 1/2. So we have 15 equals 11, and then this would be plus 4, which also checks. Remember, we could have also checked this solution by graphing both linear equations, and this would be the point of intersection. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.